Power Director 16, let's do a whoosh effect and see how it looks in Power Director 16 right there! Ooh, that looks so cool. Let's bring it in again! Yes! The whoosh effect in Power Director 16 fast! Again! Again! Yes, that is my truck. Let's check out how to do this! Okay, let's have a look at how to do the whoosh effect in Power Director 16. This is actually a pretty easy effect, but it's just placing all your elements together. You can do it with photos, you can do it with video, whatever you like. So the first thing I would suggest you do is you get the videos in place and where you're going to place them. Okay, so let's say I'm going to run this video, and that's probably a bit too long, so I'm going to cut it. Get rid of this back end, okay? Now I want to go into something else, so maybe I'll go into this, I don't know, this groundhog picture here. And again, I'll bring it down here to cut it for editing purposes so you can check this out. And let's throw some pictures in. So then I'll throw this in. Then I'll throw this in. And then I'll throw my truck in. And yes, it is my truck. Okay, so we got the images a little bit bigger. Not bad. Got to stretch this one out. That's one of my dogs. Looks like I need to take her in and get her teeth cleaned. Wow. And that's one of my other dogs, actually. Okay, so you'll notice I left these spaces here. And this is for you to understand what I'm going to do next. On the left side here, we're going to go to the transition room. And in here, type slide. Because we're looking for a slide. We got this type of slide here. You can use those too if you want. But this particular slide seems to work best. Okay. And all I'm going to do is drag this basically down on the image. See that? Just on that one. And then I'm going to drag it down on that one. And then I'm going to drag it down on that one. And then I'm going to drag it on that one. So now every one of these have a slide. But the problem is they're going the wrong way. So we're actually going to click this here, you know, this little fancy letter A here, and then we're going to click on modify. And then we're going to have some choices here, up, down, left, right. We're going to go right. See, goes that way. Well, I could go left too. Yeah, maybe right looks better. So I could go right on that one. And then the trick is here is the duration you're going to set. Okay. I can click duration here and this box pops up, or I can edit here. Now, normally set this to zero, and in maybe 15 seconds, maybe less, you're going to have to play with it and see what you like. Okay, and we've got that one done. Then we're going to go down here and click on this one. Notice how it highlights? And we're back to doing the same thing. I guess I'll go right to left, change that to my zero, change that to 15 seconds, and again over here. Click on that one. And we're literally going through this process of clicking the A, and we're clicking modify over and over here, setting our time limit, you know, and then which way we want to go, left, right, up, down, whatever. And I don't know, I'll send this one down, but you can do them any way you want. So now that we got all that worked out, I'll grab this and I'll just kind of move it over. And then I'll move this over, you know, get them all touching, all looking good. Okay, we can shorten these videos. We can shorten the pictures. I mean, we can get pretty crazy with this whoosh or swoosh effect that you want to call it. Okay, let's see how this looks now when it's all put together. And we'll run it through. And right about here is where we want to see that whoosh. There it is there. And then we want to see it again. I went the other way, and then I want to see it again. Now I could shorten these image ups to be a little bit quicker, you know, so I could actually take this and bring this in to make it a little bit faster, trim and move clips, so this way it pulls them all in. Again, grab this one, move it in, trim and move, this way it pulls them all in, and of course I could move my truck in. But it really doesn't have any pizzazz with it just swiping and not doing nothing, right, because we're using the slide here. Under transition. So we do need to toss in one more small effect, and that's actually some music. And that's the actual swoosh effect itself. So we kind of want to drop it there. You'll see where the blue line is. And again, right there. And again, right here. And again, right here. Everywhere we actually put that transition. So now it's going to look pretty cool. It's going to sound pretty cool. And I'll have a link in the description box. This is just off the YouTube library, the swoosh effect, and where you can pick it up. So let's run it now. Swoosh. See how that sounds? That makes it pop, you know. And there you go. That's how you actually do the swoosh effect. The swoosh, swoosh effect in PowerDirector 16. And again, you can actually go down to your transition room or F8 and actually go through and select a whole bunch of you. You don't have to use the one I used. I mean, there's a whole bunch in here you could play with. Shorten up your times and mess with them and modify them. But you can get pretty creative with the swoosh effect in PowerDirector 16. And if you have it, guys, hit the subscribe, give me a comment, tell me what you want to see, hit the bell, hoorah. Catch you guys on the next one. PowerDirector 16, let's do a whoosh effect and see how it looks in PowerDirector 16 right there. Ooh, that looks so cool. Let's bring it in again. Yes! The whoosh effect in PowerDirector 16 fast. Again. Again. Yes, that is my truck. Let's check out how to do this.